Welcome to Strength of Materials, Simple Stress and Strain. So we have seen one of the relationship between the elastic constants in the previous video, that is elastic modulus to the bulk modulus. Now in this video, we are going to learn the relationship between modulus of elasticity and modulus of rigidity. So modulus of elasticity, we denote it by E. And modulus of rigidity, we denote it by G or C. So it depends upon what nomenclature we are going to consider also. So it defending that rigidity, G is going to come. So let us take it as capital G itself only. So consider a square element ABCD of a sides A subjected to pure shear as shown in the figure. So the figure is in this way. So this particular part of the square sides element is going to have the sides A, B, C, D and the sides of AA. Now the pure shear Q is acting in this way. So shear is acting here, shear is acting in this way, shear is acting here and shear is acting here. Clear? So shearing is going to act in the particular part. Now we are able to see that A, E, C dash, D is a deformed shape due to shear Q, which will be coming in this format. So this is the deformed shape, that is A, E, C dash will be here and D. So this particular part, when we are going to consider into the particular relationship, we will take first part. Let us drop a perpendicular from B on a diagonal as BF. So this is the diagonal ED or DE. On this we will draw a perpendicular which is shown as B to F. This is the perpendicular B to F. Now let phi be the shear strain and G be the modulus of rigidity. So this particular phi is the shear strain. As we have seen in the earlier, the shear strain as the moment in the very first starting videos, what is shear strain, shear stress, in that part shear strain is the change. So this is the particular change of the thing, what is the amount of changing is there, that phi is be the shear strain and G be the modulus of rigidity considering in this relationship. So going through this part, let us see what is the further part of the derivation. Strain in the diagonal. So strain in the diagonal we need to consider, that is B to D. Okay, so B to D, the we need to find out how we will be find out. D to E is the first part, okay, then DF is the smaller part. So elongated part is DE and the part of DF which will be able to get us as DF division. Then we will get the diagonal strain in the BD, because earlier BD was the diagonal, earlier B to D was the diagonal. So that diagonal has going to move in this particular part. So what is the strain in that diagonal we need to determine, that is DE minus DF divided by DF. That is what the original part which is there. Now coming to further part, which is equals to EF. So what is that DE, DE minus DF? DE minus DF is EF. EF divided by this part of D to B, or we can say DF itself will become as D to B, DB. Clear? So that we can say. Now what is D to B? So that we can consider it as the square element, it is there. So diagonal will be of a square element as one of the side and its square root, because it is a diagonal part of a square, we can say. So A root of square 2, that is we can say, but here DB is that we will consider in terms of AB vertical, AB root 2. So that part is, this is EF divided by AB root 2. So here two times are inserted in this, which we can say. So see, this is the first diagonal, which was earlier without any deformation. So this diagonal length is how much as per the part FB DF it is. Now DF we can write it as DB. Now DB is what this diagonal length. So this diagonal length will be what A root 2. What is A? It is BC, it is CD, it is AD, it is AB. So taking it as AB root 2. Clear? This part is next. So since the angle of deformation is very small, we can assume. So this part of deformation, it is very small. We can assume it as, see, BEF. It is 45 degrees. It is not 450. It is 45 degrees. BEF. This part of angle is 45 degrees. Hence, EF. EF equal to BE. Very small. We can take it as equating equal length only. So, equal part. So, we can say this as EF as BE cos of 45. This angle is 45. Okay. So, we took EF as BE, this BE as cos of 45 in terms of EF. So, this is the part. Clear? Therefore, strain in the diagonal BD. Now, what is the strain in the diagonal BD? Strain in the diagonal BD is EF divided by DB. EF divided by DB. What is EF? EF is BE cos 45. So, BE cos 45. What is BD? BD or DB is AB root 2. AB root 2. So, here we are having the divisional part in between that. BE cos 45 divided by AB root 2 is the strain in the diagonal B to D. So, the further relationship goes in this part. Since the diagonal, strain in the diagonal is what? So, that is A tan phi cos 45. A tan phi cos 45 is what is in this way. So, this part is BE cos 45. BE cos 45 is what? A part. A, we will take it as tan of phi. A is tan of phi. This particular angle is same, no, there. Now, this is what? How we are going to consider this part? So, that is A tan of phi. So, this is the side A tan of phi. Then we are able to get it. So, that is A tan of phi cos of 45, which is divided by A root 2, which is equals to half tan phi. So, half of tan phi is what we can consider because cos 45 is what? 1. So, in that part we will be considering this here. So, half of tan is very small, angle is very small. We will consider half of phi it is as a strain in the diagonal. So, half part of the particular shear strain is equals to half is the strain in the diagonal. Now, half phi. Phi is what? Phi is known to us, which is in the previous part. Shear stress upon modulus of rigidity, Q upon G. Okay, Q upon G. So, half divided by half into Q upon G will be the first equation. Pure shear gives rise to axial stress, axial tensile stress Q along the diagonal DB and axial compressive Q at the right angles. So, there will be two types of following figures. One side it will be compressive, one side it will be tension. So, Q is in the diagonals as the DB. DB will be acting in the diagonals, which is tensiles part. Other part will be under compression, which is A and C are under compression. So, these two stresses cause tensile strain along the diagonal DB. Clear? Then, this part I was saying. So when we consider the part of thing, this is under tension and this part is under compression in the manner. So we can see this is under tension, this is under compression. So this is the compression part and this is the tension part which will be acting. So this is the diagonal DB is in the tensile strain. Tensile strain along the DB is given by equal to Q upon E. Q upon E, stress upon Young's modulus plus mu into. So strain we are considering, no, tensile strain. Previous videos we know this. Strain in one angle is what? Change in the length and Poisson's ratio, that strain. Okay, that part. Q divided by E plus mu into Q upon E, which is equals to stress, it is Young's modulus, multiplied by 1 plus mu, it is Poisson's ratio. This is the second equation and this is the first equation. Now from equation 2 and 3, sorry, this is equation 1 and 2, we can write 1 and 2. Okay, from equation 1 and 2, so this strain in diagonal and this tensile strain in DB both are same. We are equating them. We are now equating them. Okay, so this part is G. Please make a small correction. This is G, half Q upon G is equals to Q E 1 plus mu it is. Okay, from equation 1 and 2. This equation reduces to E is equals to 2 G 1 plus mu. So Q gets cancelled, 2 into G comes on this side, E goes on this side. So we able to get this as E is equals to 2 times G into 1 plus mu. Okay. This is the relationship between modulus of elasticity and modulus of rigidity. So this is modulus of rigidity and this is modulus of elasticity. E is Young's modulus, G is modulus of rigidity. G is modulus of rigidity. Clear? Okay. So make a correction. This is 1 and this is 2. Here it is G, small g. Okay. The capital G, this part. Relationship between elasticity, modulus of elasticity and modulus of rigidity and bulk modulus. So there are three terms: modulus of elasticity, modulus of rigidity and bulk modulus. So what is modulus of elasticity? It is E. What is modulus of rigidity? It is G. What is bulk modulus? It is K. Okay, E, G, K is the three relationships. So first we have E, Young's modulus in terms of bulk modulus, 3k 1 minus 2 times mu, and one more we have E is equals to 2g 1 plus mu. These are the two equations which we have. This is modulus of elasticity and bulk modulus. This is modulus of elasticity and modulus of rigidity. By eliminating mu, so we are removing this part of mu between the above equations, two equations, we can get the relationship between E, G and K free from mu. Free from mu means we are removing the Poisson's ratio. From equation E is equals to 2G 1 plus mu, this equation, mu can be written as E divided by 2G minus 1. And substituting it in equation, E is equals to 3k 1 minus 2 mu. So what is the value of mu? We'll substitute here. So that comes E is equals to 3k 1 minus 2 E divided by 2g minus 1. Okay, this part is entered here. Now substituting that, we are simplifying. So it comes E is equals to 3k 1 minus, when we are considering, 1 minus E upon G plus 2. Okay, so this is minus coming outside that time, and again considering, so 2 gets cancelled here and 1 minus e upon g is remaining, 1 plus 1 will become as 2 the power. So now considering here again, so 1 minus plus 2, it is 3k 3 minus e upon g, so it is plus 2, it is plus 1, so becomes as 3. So e upon g is in minus term, e upon g is in minus term, so e is equals to 3k 3 minus e upon g into bracket. Now what happens, 3 into 3 9k minus 3 into k multiplied by e, 3k e divided by g, it is again minus as it is. Now rearranging these terms, we find out therefore e is equals to 1 plus 3k upon g. So k we are taking outside, no, e is coming inside, 9k we are keeping here. When we take on this side, it is in the plus. When we take it on this side, it will become as plus. So e 1 minus 1 plus 3k upon g, so e we are taking common, so from this e and this e comes outside, 1 plus 3k upon g is equals to 9k. Then part second one, e g plus 3k, so g LCM we are multiplying, which comes like this, k and 3 g plus 3k divided by g is equals to 9k. It is second equation. So in this equation is there already, this is also there. Now after rearranging, we find out this equation. Earlier the same equation is in this way, that is, this is rearranged, this part is rearranged. So when we rearrange this part, we are able to get this equation, e is equals to 9kg divided by g plus 3k. So this is the relationship between Young's modulus, bulk modulus and modulus of rigidity. So most important part of relationship always asked, so go through this relationships. Thank you, see you in the next video.